The Bible says, "Then did they spit in his face and buffeted him, and others smote him with the palms of their hands." Can you picture this scene, dear child of God? The Savior, the sinless Son of God, whose face is adorned and who's with light that outshines the sun, taking the spit of some ungodly sinner upon him. Can you fathom the shame your Savior bore so that you might be saved? The Bible says in Isaiah 50, verse 6, that Jesus Christ hid not his face from shame and spitting. The act of spitting in someone's face is the ultimate act of degradation, the ultimate gesture to bring shame upon another person. In Numbers chapter 12, verse 14, speaking of Miriam's judgment, the Bible says, "The Lord said unto Moses, if her father had but spit in her face, should she not be ashamed 7 days?" Your first mention of spit in the face deals with shame. And when Jesus Christ took that spit in his face, he was bearing your shame. And when he was reviled, he reviled not again. How much more vile a gesture than the spit of some cursed infidel cast upon your Savior's brow. And yet he did it for you. He bore your shame. And today, dear child of God, may you never be ashamed of Jesus, because Jesus was never ashamed of you. And you wouldn't think of spitting in the Savior's face, but do your actions and your attitudes and your disobedience and your cold heart, do they cast the same shame in your Savior's face? Do they bring him dishonor? Do they cause him regret? Do they spit in his face once again? May today be a day where you bring joy to your Savior's face and no shame. He bore it for you. May you bear the reproach for him and bring him honor and glory this day.